I'm Tyler Jehola, and welcome to our demo of Shape. Today I'm going to show you how to get started with the platform by linking your data sources, creating your first client, creating your first budget, and navigating through the dashboard. The first step after you set up the account is to connect your data sources. So go ahead and click this button in the left-hand nav, and as you can see, we work with Google AdWords, Bing Ad Center, and Facebook Advertising. We also have two-way APIs with all three different connections, meaning not only can we pull in data for analysis, we can also push back any changes of any kind. So the first thing you want to do is actually hit this Add AdWords login or Add Bing or Add Facebook login. We'll take you to a quick three-step prompt. You should be able to have all of your data sources linked up in under a minute, typically. Once you've completed all that linking, go ahead and click this dashboard button and we'll take you back to the dashboard. Now, as you can see, everything is still blank. We built Shape this way to empower the analyst to structure their clients and budgets however they see fit. So you can build one budget per client if you prefer, or build multiple budgets for a client, separating search, retargeting, display, Facebook, or combining them all together. So we're going to go ahead and create our first client. Hit this Create Client button up here in the top right. First thing we do is name it. We'll just call this one Vandalay Industries. Next, we select our currency. Now, one of the great things about our APIs are that we pull the figures directly from Google, Bing, and Facebook. So you only need to select the symbol of your currency for consistency's sake. If you don't see your currency in here, send us a message at support@shape.io, and we'll build it in within a day or so. Go ahead and use dollars for this example. Hit submit. That creates our first client. Next, we're going to create our first budget. Hit this Create Budget button right here. Scroll down, we're going to go ahead and name our first budget. We'll call this one Long Matches. Then we put in our budget amount. Say this one is $1,500. Next, we're going to select the date range. So our default is a monthly budget, starting on the 1st. If it does start in the middle of the month, easily select those right here. Select the first here. If it is a custom cycle of any kind, a custom length, you can do any sort of date range from 7 days to a year. You can make it a one-time or repeating budget. Lots of options right there. For this example, again, we're just going to use that monthly budget starting on the 1st. Next, we select the budget alerts that will be sent to your email. There'll also be an in-app alert as well, but the key is that these are sent straight to your email. Go ahead and select this, and we'll say we want to be alerted when we've hit half of our budget. The key is that these are remaining, so 80% of our budget, meaning 20% left, 10% left, 5% left, 1% left. We'll get all those going. Next step is our advanced budget options. So the first one here is Autopilot. Now, Autopilot is actually the original idea that motivated our creation of Shape. By selecting Autopilot, Shape will automatically pause all campaigns within a budget when that budget cap is reached, in this case, the $1,500. Shape will also re-enable the campaigns at the beginning of the next cycle, essentially ensuring you never overspend again. And you won't miss any part of the next cycle, given that Autopilot will turn it on right at the beginning of that next cycle. Turn that on like that, and then you select this to turn it on for all campaigns. Next is our rollover. So by enabling this feature, we will automatically track any underspends or overspends and roll that remaining amount into the next cycle. You will still always see that base budget, that $1,500, you will always have that as a reference, and your rollover amount will be separate. You'll see it in a separate box there. Let's say in this case it is $150, or if you're not using Autopilot and we do happen to overspend, it's -$236. You just put that in there. That number is always editable, and now all alerts and all Autopilot, everything will be going towards that base plus or minus that rollover. So that $1,500 -$236 in this case. We'll go ahead and keep that on for this example. And the last of our advanced features here is the Smart Sync. So Smart Sync is a little bit different. If you don't separate your search, retargeting, and display campaigns into different budgets, and instead put all of those campaigns from one account into one budget, you can turn on Smart Sync, and any new campaigns built in that account will automatically be added to the budget with no manual steps needed. Go ahead and select that, and it's a little insurance policy, knowing that any new campaigns are automatically going to get tracked. You don't have to remember to do anything. Keep that one off. The last step here before we start selecting campaigns is the CCing budget alerts. So go ahead and type in any email address in here inside or outside of the organization, and they will get these same budget alerts that we created up here into their email addresses. So many of our clients will include the client-facing manager, in some cases the accounting team, so that they know exactly where each budget is, if they need to invoice, if they need to whatever. And in some cases, we do have clients who are putting their clients in these CC alerts. We've got some that white label these emails. We can do that for an extra charge. And then your clients will know immediately when they've hit 80%, 99%, 50%, anything like that, and be able to communicate with you whether to put in more or less budget, all that information. Okay, and then the last step here is to actually select the campaigns. So you can either do this one of two ways. You can click on the data source that you're looking for, you can click on the account, and then you can start finding the actual budgets. And let's see, we've got a couple here I wanted to use for this example. Here's one. Let's go with our Seattle account. There we are. And then we had a best apps one that I liked a lot. Here we are. Okay. So that's the first way to do it. The other way is to actually just select this campaigns tab, and that will open up a table full of all of your campaigns that are associated with any one of your data sources, any one of your accounts. This can be hundreds, thousands, tens of thousands, in some cases hundreds of thousands of campaigns are in this. Use this quick search filter. Say I'm looking for the one that is shape. There we go. And the other one that's shape. There we go. Now in this example, I've selected five campaigns, but from three different channels. I just wanted to show you that using shape, you can combine campaigns from anywhere, from any data source, from any account, from any channel, any way you like. This is just the example, Bing, Google, Facebook, Facebook, Facebook. After you've added in your campaigns, you've completed your budget form process, hit the submit button. This will take us back to the dashboard. And the campaigns usually load in within about 5 to 15 seconds. What you'll see here is the budget amount total, $1,500. There is our rollover amount, -$236, giving us that target amount of $1,264. And then not only do we show you the spend to date, $466 from 10/1 till 10/13 today, but it's also telling you that we are about 5% under our trend. If we did want to hit that 1264 number on the last day of the cycle, we would need to up a couple things. We are about 5% under. If we actually click into the budget, I can show you some more information. So again, we have these same figures here, spend to date. The next thing we provide for you is the ideal daily budget. Now, this is saying that $43, if spent every day for the rest of the cycle, will put us at that $1,264 on this last day. If we don't touch a thing, if we don't change bids, if we don't increase daily budgets, if we don't add keywords, although there's a million ways to increase spend here, then we will end up spending $1,204, as you can see right there by projected spend compared to that ideal line. We provide all the metrics going on for this account, for this budget as well right here. And then if you scroll down, we give you some more tables and data. This one is our budget breakdown. So it compares every campaign that's part of this budget, showing you conversions compared to the amount of spend as a percentage of this overall budget. So you can now look at this and see easily, okay, this one's spending the most. It's got the same conversions as this one, which is spending almost the least. We should certainly allocate more budget into this one if we want this budget to start performing better. Use this for any sort of analysis like that. Scroll on down and we have our decision grid that's full of all of the campaign data itself. So we give every campaign broken down. We provide all these metrics. Now, if you don't see a metric in here that you would like to see, something that you do use for your own analysis out of Google, Bing, Facebook, anywhere, please let us know. You know, we can definitely discuss that, scope it out, hopefully add it in within a few days, within a week. A lot of these different metrics, the search impression share loss due to budget, came from requests from clients. This one, average daily spend, was a big one. That's what people kept on requesting. We want to know exactly how much this budget, or this campaign rather, has spent per day compared to that daily budget so we can start figuring out that projected potential spend. Use that any way you like. We also break down ad groups, ad sets, ads, and keywords. Everything you want to see, you can compare those different campaigns to each other. You can change bids easily from here, just double click on those, hit this to pause, activate, anything like that. So going back to the dashboard, we have this one campaign here, so I'm actually going to pull up another account that has multiple, so you can sort of see what a number of different budgets look like, what all the different colors we provide. So we have a 9-color spectrum going from this this nice green, strong Kelly green color that is showing that you were pretty close to trend, all the way down to this crimson red that's showing you you're way off trend, and everything in between. So you can sort of scroll up and down, triage your account, figure out where you need to look into immediately. Here's an example, like I mentioned before, widgets, LLC. We have the display campaigns, we have the retargeting campaigns, we have the search campaigns. All one budget for one client, set up in multiple different strategies. The next thing I want to show you here is the decision grid. So click this button here up at the top, and that will take you to basically the same information, all the clients, all the budgets, but broken down into table format. So if you are working with hundreds, dozens, hundreds, thousands of different budgets, it can take a while to scroll up and down with that, with our initial dashboard there. Use this as a table to start filtering, to start sorting. You can sort on trend very easily to see, okay, these ones are the most underspent, these ones have spent zero, certainly something we should look into. All the way down to these ones are trending towards the most overspent, definitely look into those. Start pausing stuff, start lowering daily budgets, whatever you need to do. All the other information is in here as well, clicks, impressions, conversions, everything like that. You can see autopilot, you can control that, roll over all of that information. Here's our rollover amount, here's our target amount. You can also use this screen to change your budgets quickly. Double click, enter. It immediately gets changed, all of these settings in shape, change immediately using that, that button there. So quickly change all the budgets you need. And then this is our sort of first stage towards reporting. If you hit this button right here, this takes you to the past cycle. If you are doing monthly budgets, then you are looking at the past month reports, and you can go back as far back as you were on Shape platform here. You can get all the breakdowns of clicks, impressions, conversions, spend obviously is the big one. So we now have a lot of clients using us more of as an organizational solution, pulling these reports. You can export them into a CSV or into a PDF, sending them over to accounting. Accounting immediately knows how much each client has spent. If that client has multiple budgets, knows how much each budget spent. Very easily use this report as an organizational solution. Go back into the dashboard here. And the last thing I want to show you here are our alerts. So I mentioned we do have the budget alerts in-app. These are the same ones that get emailed to you. So you can see, okay, 90% here, 75% here. Click this button to click into that budget. Click clear if you know what's going on already very easily. The other ones here, this is the big one, the system alerts. These are showing you all new campaigns that have been built in any one of your data sources, any one of your accounts. So we want to use this as sort of an insurance policy to let you know that there are campaigns that exist that are not in shape currently. You definitely want to put them into some sort of budget and start tracking that spend. You want to make sure that you're not missing any tracking when using the Shape platform. So this is our insurance policy. Just very easily say, oh great, that's right, I did build this campaign. This one's part of Good Life. Click add to budget, done, immediately gets tracked in that budget itself. Well, that is Shape platform in a nutshell. So if you do have any questions, please contact us at sales@shape.io. Otherwise, happy budgeting.